Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss optional chaining. Optional chaining helps us to see whether an object really exists. It can also avoid the program to stop when an object does not exist. If the object doesn't really exist, the program can just execute as usual. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I just have a title and a heading. And this HTML file is linked to a certain JavaScript file whose name is called myscript.js. And this JavaScript file is stored in the JS folder. And for the JS file, I'm going to use the strict mode. That's why I have to say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. And now I'm going to discuss optional chaining. It helps us to avoid error when object is null or undefined. If there is an object that is null or undefined, the rest of the program can still execute. So suppose I now have a certain object with this kind of information, some key value pairs and a method. And for this key value pair, it is simply another object. Okay, so for this program, I add an alert window called end of program at the end in order to test whether the program can continue to run when there is some problem with the object accessed. Now, I'm going to do something like this one. I want to access the value coming from the student.testResults.science. So the student refers to this particular object, and I'm going to access the test results key. But you can see that the student object has no such key. And of course, the science subject also doesn't exist in the student object. So if I really run this program, there might be some problem. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that when I press the reload button, I'm not able to get the result. And also, the final statement here isn't able to be executed as well. That means the program really stops at this statement. So if I want the program to go further and bypass this kind of object existence problem, I can have an idea like this by using the optional chaining approach. The idea is like this one. I use the question mark followed by a period instead of just one period. Suppose I'm not really sure whether this object really exists or not. If I'm not sure whether the object exists or not, I just use a question mark followed by a period to indicate that I'm suspicious about the existence of this particular object. And if the object before this pattern doesn't really exist, then, of course, the object is undefined, but the program can still continue in this case. So let me try again. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the alert window gives me the value called undefined. And of course, you can expect that the program can continue to run. Yes, the end of program can be shown. That means the final line here can be executed, and the program is able to handle the existence problem of your objects and give you the undefined result instead of halting it at this location. Okay. So this is the power of optional chaining in determining whether a certain object exists or not. And let me show you another example of using optional chaining. Suppose I want to set up another object. Now I have an empty object called student2. There is no function inside or no other key value pairs inside. If I want to execute a certain method, like this one, it is of course problematic. Of course, you know that student2 has no describe function. The describe function also belongs to the first object called student. If I really want to execute this method from student2, you can expect some error coming out. Save. Reload. Yes, when I press the reload button, the program stops at this line of statement, and I'm not able to go to the end of the program to show this statement, end of program. So if we are not sure whether this function really exists in this object definition, I can use the optional chaining approach again. So the idea is to use a question mark followed by a period. When I use this pattern, it is able to bypass the statement when that function doesn't really exist in the object and nothing is shown, and the rest of the program can be executed. So let me try it now. If I'm not sure whether this particular function exists or not, I have to add the question mark and the period before I type the round bracket pair. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you can see that I can go to the end of the program statement, which is the last statement of the JavaScript file. And you can see that since the describe function doesn't really exist in student2 object, the optional chaining approach helps me to bypass that line. And this line becomes useless, and I'm able to do the rest of my program. So this is the power of optional chaining, to help us see whether a function really exists in a certain object. Okay, we can also notice that we can use a pair of square brackets to get an object property. So let me try another example. Suppose I have a certain variable called subject and the content is a string called science. You can see that the word subject is a variable. So if you want to indicate a key which is a variable, I have to use a pair of square brackets. And of course, I can also use the optional chaining technique that is just a question mark followed by a period. So if I'm not sure whether student2 has this particular exam result object, I can add the optional chaining pattern before that object. And of course, the subject variable represents a certain string content. So it is quite sensible for us to see whether student2 has exam results and whether science is included in the exam results. So let me save it and reload. Yes, you can see that the result is undefined. So student2 has no exam result object, and of course I cannot find out the subject called science, which is represented by a variable right now. And after that, I can go to the end of the program, which is the final alert window shown at the end of the JavaScript file. So you can see that optional chaining is quite useful in that we can investigate whether a certain object exists or not. If the object doesn't exist, the result just turns out to be undefined. Or if we want to execute a certain function, but the function doesn't exist in a certain object, then we will just bypass that particular function by using the optional chaining approach shown here. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.